Enjoy your tea. It's so good to have you back. I really missed you. Where were you off to? You'll have to tell me all about it tomorrow. You met a dragon.
You're joking with me, aren't you? Oh.
Well,
that does sound very exciting.
I'm so sorry. I've been looking at these marks on your waistcoat for a while. Would you mind if I got rid of those? You also have a button missing. Yeah. Okay. You know me. I'd just be staring the whole time. I don't want to be rude.
Okay. Let's pick out a button first.
Okay.
Oh, so Gandalf sent you up to this?
Of course he would.
How could he?
Right.
What do you think? Would this one work?
Do the trick. Okay. Let's close this back up. And so just going to attach that in here. Just going to put that through here.
You've really lived 10 lifetimes on that journey, haven't you?
Well, were you thinking about maybe writing it all down?
I don't know, I think that might be fun.
Yeah. I think all adventures should be written down. I always find them very fascinating to read.
So the button is sorted.
Right.
Now for the marks. Just take this cloth here.
How's the bread? Is it good?
Very good. And then I'm just going to
take a little bit of this liquid.
Made with flowers from my garden. So, it should smell very nice. I'm also removing the dirt.
Will you be joining the celebrations tonight? Not quite sure yet. Feeling a bit under the weather, are you? Understandable after such a long journey. Gently dabbing the cloth here.
You know, I've been working on some new recipes lately, and I really want to hear your advice on them. I know you've always been really fond of my cooking, so I'd like to know if there's something that I could maybe improve upon, or maybe, I don't know, just add something little here and there. I'll make sure you keep that, just like so.
Okay.
Mhm. That should dry in about an hour or so. So, if you don't like the feeling, we can always take it off and just put it to the side. You prefer that?
Well, of course.
There. No, it doesn't feel uncomfortable.
Good.
Right. Got a bit of a headache. Well, don't forget to drink up all the tea. I can add some more honey if you'd like.
Yeah.
Well, I can see up here you do actually have a few branches in there. Do you mind if I just get them out real quick?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm just going to also brush your hair if you'd like. Maybe braid it a little bit. Okay. I'm going to just pluck and pluck and pluck, 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 pluck.
Good.
Okay. Now, where did I put my brush? To use a comb instead. It's got these little bristles on the side. Kind of sounds like a cat purring. So we're just going to use this, okay? And gently get rid of any knots. Just anything that might be a little bit uncomfortable. How's everybody else doing from your journey?
Yeah.
I'm sure they're glad to be back. Well, they would complain about not having enough food, wouldn't they? Yes, well, our meals are all very important. I don't know why the other, well, the elves and the humans, I don't know why they haven't caught on. The idea of having multiple meals. Yes, especially since our food is so incredibly tasty. Fresh from the garden. Yes. We all cook with love, don't we? It's the best way to cook. Like, we could actually test out the chamomile oil later on that I got from the chamomiles in my garden. We could give you maybe a little face massage, scalp massage. Would you be interested in that? Mm-hmm. No problem. It's my treat to you. I haven't seen you in such a long time. I think that's that. I'd say we only braid the front part here. We pull the hair forward a little tiny bit. And then just take one strand, second, third. Just gently braid that together. Just very, very loosely. We don't need to even apply any band or anything. Give it a bit of that kind of shape there. And this side, of course, just getting one strand, second, third, and then just... There we go. Twine that, and then... See if that's the same length overall. As a matter of fact, would you mind if I drew you for a little bit?
Yeah?
Thank you. Well, you see, the thing is,
Yes. You know how last year I made those hats?
Yes.
I think some of them would go really well with that waistcoat that you're wearing.
Yes.
They can be quite festive if you style them accordingly. Maybe with some berries. Maybe add some leaves. Well, I thought I would just draw you wearing one of the hats, if you don't mind. You like the book?
Yes.
This was actually a gift from Gandalf. Believe it or not, yes. He conjured it up just within seconds.
Yes.
I love the illustrations on the back. Kind of remind me a little bit of us, but mixed with, I don't know, a little magic, I suppose. Since we don't have tree stems and berries growing from our heads. No, I'm afraid I don't know what an ent is. What is that? Talking trees. Maybe he was inspired. Who knows? Well, let's see then. Start with the shape of your face here. Just the very basic outline here. And then add the hat on top. Add fabric. I actually started designing these because I was looking into making some new sun hats. So I figured, why not make more? So, create these beautiful curls that you have. Poke through up this ear as well, of course. Add some shadow. Yes, my hair has grown quite long, hasn't it? My ears don't even poke through anymore. Out and the waistcoat. Some shadow. Okay, and there come the facial features. A bit of a nose here. Eyebrows. I always find that a little bit difficult. There we go. The pupil in the middle. Just being very delicate here. And then the lips. And the freckles. Lovely freckles. Shadow here. The cheekbones. Okay. don't worry about having to sit still. That's okay. Alright. So. Then we add is a very rough sketch, but what do you think? I mean, I think it looks like you a little bit, I'd say. But yes, I desperately wanted to draw you with one of the hats that I made. All nicely felted. Yeah. You like it? Oh, that's good. You could try them on later if you'd like. I'm actually trying out some new fabrics right now that I put together. So, I mean, this is still work in progress, but this would be part of the bow that you could be wearing. So it's a very beautiful tint of colour, not too strong. And also shimmers really nicely in the light. And back here I added some stars. It was inspired by one of the wonderful stories that Gandalf was telling the children lately. Yeah. It's not actually as uncomfortable as you think. Yeah, give it a feel. It looks spiky, but it's not. Yes, this is one of them. And then the other that I have here is actually this one, which has this small, well, floral type of look. Also attached to the same bow, but this one, I was thinking of maybe making a type of petticoat and then adding different layers. Yeah. Also lots of pockets for gardening, of course. Speaking of gardening, I did tend to your garden while you were gone, and you were growing the most wonderful garlics and cucumbers and eggplants. So wonderful. I don't know what you did to keep them alive for so long. I mean, the weather was very good, I have to say, but still, absolutely wonderful. You know, we could exchange recipes now if you'd like, or we could maybe set up a day where we could get together and we all cook each other something. Yeah, we could also invite Mary, Pippin, Sam. Yeah. Gandalf if he has time. I know he's always busy. Yeah. Okay. Well, I actually wanted to tell you about this wonderful tomato soup that I created the other day. Let me tell you. Well, yes, I actually did take some garlic from your garden. I apologise. I didn't know when you'd be coming back, and I figured I'd better take it before it goes bad. Yeah. So, basically what I did was I took fresh garlic, I chopped off the top bit, put it on a tray with a lot of fresh big tomatoes, some onions, some beautiful herbs. I put in some freshly ground pepper as well, which was very tasty. One red pepper, and I put it into the oven for around, I want to say half an hour or so. And I really let all the beautiful smells just combine, and oh, it was so tasty. So I took it out, and I really mashed it up really, really neatly into this paste, added hot water. And I tell you, it is the most wonderful soup I've ever had. It was delicious. If you don't really like the consistency of, like, the tomato skin, you could peel it off. But I think it just added that really nice extra, I don't know, the flavour, you know? So, so good. You have a dish that you always liked? What is that then? Oh, okay. So you make your own pasta. Okay. Oh. With garlic and lemon. Interesting. Do you mind sharing the recipe with me? Yeah? Okay, hold on. So flour, water for the pasta. Mm-hmm. And do you let that completely dry, or...? Okay. Right, the garlic. How many cloves? Hmm. Yeah, okay. How much lemon? Hmm. Yes, I do love garlic. The more garlic, the better. Okay. Okay, some butter. And a little bit of what? A little bit of milk. Ah, so this is like a creamy pasta dish. I see. And cheese. What type of cheese? Hmm, that does sound very good. And so you throw all that in the pan. Okay, so you make the pasta separately. Mmm, that does sound really tasty. Would you say that is a type of food for dinner or supper? Second breakfast? Probably not second breakfast. Although, who am I to judge? Incredible. We really have to get together and cook sometime. Yeah. Fantastic. Oh, my hand has been a little achy recently. Too much gardening, I suppose. I have been using this really nice oil mixture, actually, with chamomile, like I mentioned, and rose. Mmm, really soothing for the muscles. Your hands are hurting as well. Do you want me to give you a little hand massage? That's no problem, I promise. Yeah, let me see. Put it over here. Okay, so we're not going to use too much, obviously, because this is oil. Water, so very, very different texture. We don't need too much. Okay. So, give me your right hand. Mm-hmm. So, I'm going to work from the inside of the hand to the outside. Okay. Working on the inner palm, and then moving up to the fingers, okay? Individually applying pressure to thumb, index, middle finger, ring finger, and the pinky. Turning the hand around, covering it with oil here, and again on the other side, just going around in circle movements, and going backwards this time using pinky, ring finger, middle finger, index, and your thumb. Okay, you also want to make sure that you get some oil onto the actual nail and the cuticles. Good. Smells great, doesn't it? I agree. Okay, other hand please. from the inside, outwards to fingers, first thumb, index, middle finger, ring finger, pinky, cover, and put some oil here, and then again going backwards, pinky, ring finger, middle finger, index, and your thumb. Right, there we go. Just very gently massaging that in. There. You can just rest your hands together now to really keep that oil in the skin. Yeah? Okay. Does that feel alright? Yeah. Lovely. Okay. Well, if you're finished with your food and your drink, we could go on to the scalp massage. Yeah? And should you fall asleep, that is no problem at all. You can always stay here for as long as you like. Yeah? Okay then. Right. Shall we head over? Yeah. I think it's a little bit more cozy over there. Yeah. You don't want to fall asleep and then on the floor. Okay then. Let's head over. Pressure is too strong, you just let me know, okay? Okay. Not going to apply too much oil or too much pressure since we just braided your hair nicely. Just enough to make you feel relaxed. Well, my friend, I will wake you up later with a nice cup of tea. Have sweet dreams.